Have you ever looked at a laser pointer and noticed that it looks a little bit different than normal light? Lasers seem to have a bit of a graininess to them, don't they? I've heard people describe it as a sort of glint or glimmer, or even a sparkle. It seems to be stationary until our perspective shifts, and more mysterious yet, it also extends off the object and into open air. But what exactly is this, and why do we see it? Ever since I was a kid, I thought that this looked cool, but I didn't understand what was going on. In fact, it's actually kind of a funny story. Oh no, I said kids. It's almost the new year, and that means that COPPA is going to kick in pretty soon. Just what we needed. Another ad apocalypse on YouTube. Why do there need to be so many regulations for advertising to children? When will this nightmare end? Which is eventually why my doctor prescribed me these. So anyway, now that I'm older and perhaps a little bit wiser, I can actually try and explain what causes this laser speckle. What we are witnessing is what optics experts call laser speckle. Speckle is the bright and dark spots that appear around a laser dot or within the laser dot itself. You only see this in lasers and not in normal rays of light, like a flashlight, because laser light has a special property called coherence. Coherence is a property of laser beams that means that the light coming out of them has exactly the same frequency and exactly the same phase. Coherence has actually unlocked many important fields of study, such as interferometry, which we can thank for the detection of gravitational waves, as well as the fabrication of holograms, and ultimately, coherence and interference are the culprit for laser speckle as well. Now, as you can see from this laser...
It's all YouTube's fault, saying that their site is for kids 13 and up while bragging publicly about YouTube being the most visited site for kids. Why do I have to keep paying for their constant screw-ups? And now I need to go through all the effort of labeling each video as made for kids or not? What a hassle.
Anyway, so when coherent light hits a matte object, such as a sheet of paper, what we get is a thing called diffuse reflection, which means that the laser beam scatters randomly afterward, and this is where interference takes over. You can try this yourself with a stagnant body of water, have two objects creating regular ripples, and there are areas where the waves add, called constructive interference, and where they cancel out, called destructive interference. The same is true for light waves reflecting off of a matte surface. They randomly interfere to make bright spots and dark spots, in what we have come to know as speckle. And so long as neither you or the object moves, the speckle grain will always stay in the same spot, because the light from the laser is pretty consistent. But if you change your perspective, then the speckle moves with you, because now you're looking at a completely new random set of reflections. And that's it! A simple answer for a simple question that has plagued me for far too long. So, I want to wish everybody a Merry, Merry Crips. Oh look, YouTubers complaining about vaguely written laws. Let's take a look. Wait, what? Qualifiers for kids' content are vibrant graphics, sound effects, use of animation? I do all of these things! Oh no, I'm in trouble. What do? I can get rid of all those things, and then I can hope and pray that the FTC doesn't look at any of my previous videos. Wait, I have a plan. It's going to be perfect. I can scare away all the kiddies with content so boring, it's borderline unwatchable. Just like school. Did I say the video was over? Because... actually, no discussion of laser speckle would be complete without taking statistical mathematics into account. I mean, come on, guys. Am I right? I mean, it's not like any viewer is crazy enough to sit through an explanation twice as long using professional optical equipment and computer simulation in unprecedented detail. But if such an attempt were to be made, it would probably look something like this. Let's begin by discussing coherence in greater detail. Every light source, including lasers, has a maximum distance that it can travel before it becomes incoherent. The two waves in the bottom left show how two waves of slightly different frequency can see a phase shift over time. One of the largest sources of frequency shift is Doppler broadening, which is simply redshift and blue shift occurring while the photons are bouncing around the laser cavity. We can see from the table the coherence distance of various light sources, such as incandescent bulbs, which have an extremely short coherence distance, all the way up to lasers, which have a very high coherence distance. The speckle pattern created is strongly dependent on the amount that the light is cohered. Incoherent light will make little to no pattern, while strongly cohered light will approximate perfect Gaussian noise. There are two types of laser speckle to be aware of. The first and simplest is objective laser speckle, called that because it will always look the same, no matter how you view it. Take, for example, the laser shining through this frosted glass onto a sheet of paper. The speckle pattern is created at the glass, not the paper, so we will always see the same projection of that speckle pattern on the paper. More complicated is subjective speckle, which introduces perspective dependence into the mix. An example of this would be light scattered from a projection screen onto an image system and a sensor, such as the human eye and retina. The fact that speckle occurs at the eye and not on the object is why we can see the speckle leave the object and extend into open air. Here are two equations that will help us define speckle mathematically. The first is contrast, which is defined as the quotient of the standard deviation of the random distribution and the mean intensity. I wrote a program that calculates these values using images I took earlier. We may also mathematically represent the diameter of each speckle dot by these two equations, for objective speckle and subjective speckle, respectively. We can also simply measure the speckle size on our photograph if we know the real size of each pixel. Imaging techniques like this, LSI for short, are often used in biomedical imaging to create a speckle pattern when a laser beam interacts with some sample tissue. The beam scatters below the surface of the tissue and creates a speckle pattern that a computer can analyze to learn about the tissue's composition and structure. Speckle is not always desired. For example, laser projectors often attempt to eliminate speckle to increase image fidelity. The image on the left has not been filtered, and the image on the right is after filtering. One of many possible speckle-reducing filters can look like this. And only now can we end our discussion about laser speckle, now that we have, you know, talked about it to its fullest extent. Thank you for sitting through that. It was necessary. So, as you can see, laser speckle is a very important and not at all interesting topic. Alright, that's it. Thanks for watching!
Finally safe. I can publish this video. No kid is gonna sit through that. Go back to playing Fortnite, you stupid kids. Can't sue me now, FTC. First comment is coming in. First, to be expected. Second comment. I'm 9 years old and had a question about how you calculated contrast coefficient.
Why? Why are you all so curious? No. I'm for adults. I'll prove it. I wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you a Merry Christmas. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Bye.